Welcome. I'm glad you're here. This is Dale Hughes from VelocityWriting.com, where you learn to write with speed, passion, purpose, and profitability. J.R.R. Tolkien has generations of readers. They're attracted by his magical stories and his wonderful way of telling them. The Hobbit and his Lord of the Rings trilogy, and his characters, Frodo Baggins, Gandalf the Grey, Bilbo Baggins, and the sinister Gollum, will live in the minds of readers until the end of time. So, how did he create this magic? Let's look at that right now. Hey, if you're new here, please subscribe to this channel by clicking the subscribe button below. Also, click the bell icon to get a notification when I release a new video. And if you discover something helpful, please hit the like button. Want to help me and others? Leave a YouTube comment or question because your input is important. So, how did Tolkien create his magic? The first great tip is that Tolkien did not just think up imaginary worlds. He reshaped his own world into something unique, including geography, people, experiences, and beliefs. When you understand his personal background, this all becomes clear. Tolkien was born in South Africa while his British father served as a bank manager there. At age 3, he returned with his mother and brother Hilary to Britain for a short visit, but while there, his father died in South Africa. Without an income, Tolkien's mother moved in with her parents in a then rural village near Birmingham. His childhood mental images of the idyllic region, as it was at the time, influenced Tolkien in a powerful way, and scenes of those places appeared often in his books. Tolkien was homeschooled in his early years, and he gained a love for both languages and Norse legends. We know he used both of these in his later work. His mother died of type 1 diabetes when Tolkien was 12, and she gave his care over to a local Catholic priest who guided him and his brother Hilary for many years. Tolkien had a strong Christian worldview and commitment his entire life. He graduated from Oxford University in 1915. World War I added to his experiences and his later writing. Tolkien was engaged in major conflicts and saw horrific sights he captured in battle scenes in his later books. But more than just scenes, Tolkien was influenced by the great conflict between good and evil, the human cost of it all, and the eternal consequences. Tolkien became ill with trench fever and was shipped back to England in late 1916, where he endured a long recuperation in various hospitals. After the war, Tolkien used his linguistic abilities as a university professor. In 1945, he became the Merton Professor of English Literature at Oxford, and he remained there until his retirement in 1959. The writing tip within all this is that his experiences, good and bad, shaped his worldview and his writing. In Tolkien's case, the substance of events and his beliefs and feelings were genuine, and he overlaid them in his magical land. By the way, he even used personality traits of people he knew in the characters he created. Here's tip 2 from the Shire. Tolkien valued input from other writers. Most writers I know today write in isolation. They may share their work with beta readers or a few others after they have finished their first draft, but that's about it. No writer must do as critics say, but it is wise to listen to the thoughts of knowledgeable people you respect. Tolkien belonged to an Oxford group called the Inklings, a group of prominent writers. They sat around a table in a pub in Oxford nearly every week for about 20 years and read their works in progress to each other. Most importantly, the group included C.S. Lewis. C.S. Lewis encouraged him to keep writing when he was ready to give up. As a result, Tolkien's legendary sagas were born. Tolkien once said, "Lewis was for long my only audience." So the tip is this: open up to others as a writer. Find experienced writers you respect and trust and meet with them regularly. Now, it would be nice to meet with them every week in a pub in Oxford, but you can meet with them online if you must. Tip 3 from the Shire. Tolkien continued to write even though he had times of deep self-doubt. Tolkien faced the same problems you and I face. He had a full-time job, was ill at times, he worried about his children, and all the rest. He often doubted the quality of his writing. Years after publication, he wrote a letter to a friend and said, "You know, I now find The Lord of the Rings good in parts." Can you imagine that? The master was his own worst critic. What's the writing tip here? Well, it's not that you need to get rid of self-doubt. We all have it, and we need to control it. The tip is that you will never know how good your ideas are until you put them together in your story. The most essential thing any writer can do is get their whole story on the page and only then revise it. Don't revise as you write. So those are the 3 tips from the Shire. Use your own human experiences as an overlay for events in the world you create. Value input from other writers you respect. Don't write in isolation. And have confidence in the work you're doing. Keep focused on it and show yourself some respect. There's a master's writing course in each Tolkien volume. If you aspire to write great books, step into Tolkien's classroom. Read Tolkien's books once, or maybe twice, for pure enjoyment. Then read them another time or two with a notebook to jot down how his characters are introduced and evolve, and the settings and the scenes. Keep in mind that your goal is not to copy what Tolkien has done. Your goal is to learn techniques that you can apply to your own work. Use tools from his Shire tool chest to build your own worlds. Have a great writing day. Hey, thanks for watching. I want to invite you to join my free VIP Writers Club. Just click the square. Also, please subscribe to my channel to see my new videos when I post them. And here are more helpful videos selected just for you.